to line yourself up for bonuses, raises, promotions, and high-profile projects? Start working on your confidence today and raise your personal brand to the skies. You want the confidence of a 5-year-old in a Superman t-shirt. Keep watching all the way to the end to learn the secrets on how to build an unstoppable confidence at work. Welcome, my name is Johan Peterson, and today I'll walk you through how I boosted my confidence and thereby turbocharged my career. Confidence will not only make you stand out at work and make you more valuable to your employer, it will also keep you growing as you will constantly push your boundaries as you push yourself outside your comfort zone. Confidence is also a key quality of great leaders. Let's get straight into the 9 steps. Before we do though, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my future videos that will keep adding value to your career. Taking decisions at work is always hard. By understanding your company's mission, vision, and values, you can more confidently take decisions at work. Explaining or defending decisions will then be very straightforward when everything is grounded in your company's core. No matter what happens around you, focus on you, your tasks, and your goals. You will always be surrounded by distractions at work. Drama, negativity, gossip, and rumors rise above this. Focus on yourself, your results, and your impact. If you're overseeing a team, make sure they behave in the same manner as their results will reflect on you. Learn to play to and develop your strengths. Because when you do, it will help you stay engaged and energized. It will keep you self-assured and build your confidence. So I really urge you to sit down and really think through how you use your strength to do your work. If you haven't clearly identified your strengths, the things that you do better than most, then I suggest you get 360 feedback on yourself. It's oftentimes hard to know your own strengths, but an outsider's perspective is very valuable. And when you get feedback on yourself, try to get feedback from as wide of an array of people as possible. While it's more important to work on your strengths than work on your weaknesses, you still want to be aware of your weaknesses so you can minimize their impact. Everyone has blind spots that will hold them back if they're not aware of them, and can minimize them or eliminate them altogether. So whenever you get feedback on yourself, make sure you welcome constructive feedback, as it will help you identify weaknesses and blind spots. By stretching yourself to take on things outside your comfort zone, you will quickly build your confidence. You want to take on assignments that will stretch you, but where you can play to your strengths. And learn new skills and read up on the latest research. Talk to people to get new and different perspectives. Anything you can do to push yourself to be uncomfortable will help grow you and build your confidence. For some, this will be really hard, but you don't have to move mountains at first. Start with some baby steps and then gradually build over time. Always be a role model at work. Always have a positive mindset. A positive mindset means you think in terms of solutions rather than problems. Others are drawn to people who are positive and upbeat. And it's simply because it projects confidence. So this will subconsciously build your confidence over time. Being a role model also means not being emotional at work. When things go wrong, keep a calm head and focus on the best way forward. Confidence is probably the most important ingredient in your personal brand. So make sure you make this a conscious part of your personality. Then you will notice over time that this will grow into a new normal mindset for you. By putting things in perspective, it helps you keep level-headed and confident in most situations. When things inevitably go wrong or something bad happens that you obsess over, think about the impact it will have in a day, in a month, or in a year. And see these things as learning experiences that you will grow from. Don't look back, only look forward. With things as they are, knowing what you know, what can you do to make things better? Even if you don't feel confident, one thing that will instantly help boost your confidence and increase your self-esteem is body language. Being mindful and intentional about your body language can help convey a positive message about yourself. Stand up straight, shoulders back, never slouch. Same thing when you sit down, sit up straight and be present. Make eye contact with people. In conversations, you want to keep eye contact roughly 60% of the time. Walking down the office halls, keep your chin up. Don't look down, eyes forward, and say hi to people. Slow your movement and avoid fidgeting to avoid seeming and feeling anxious. Be mindful of your hands. Avoid touching your face or your neck as it projects anxiousness. Possibly the hardest, but still most important, work on controlling your inner voice. The steps that we've already gone through will undoubtedly help with this. When you learn to turn your inner voice positive and remove any negative self-talk, it will boost yourself to new heights. Your confidence will skyrocket. Encourage yourself in there. See mistakes as learnings. Don't doubt or second guess yourself. Visualize the success you've had in the past and how you will have the same success with your new assignments. Even though I am generally very confident, I have moments of self-doubt at times too, like anyone else. What I've found helps me get back on track is music. There are certain tracks that will help me get back into my groove and get my confidence back to its normal high. Of course, things will not happen overnight. Putting all of these steps to work, at work, however, will grow your confidence stronger and stronger. It will grow your personal brand and set you up for success at work. If you found this video helpful, leave a like. Here's a quick summary for you to remember all the steps. Know your company, focus on your work, play to your strengths, be aware of your weaknesses, stretch yourself, be a role model, put things in perspective, be mindful of your body language, and finally, start controlling your inner voice. I drop videos every Tuesday, so see you in a week. Thank you so much for watching.